Hello and welcome to the International Daily Roundup with People's Dispatch, where we bring to you some of the top stories of the day. Independent journalist and documentary filmmaker Abby Martin has filed a free speech lawsuit in a federal court in the United States against the state of Georgia and Georgia Southern University over the state's anti-BDS law. BDS, or Boycott, Divestment and Sanctions, is a global movement that seeks to make Israel accountable for the atrocities it commits against the people of occupied Palestine. To discuss this with us in detail, we have with us Anish. Hello, Anish. So, Anish, what would be the grounds of this case and what would be their implications?
Now, so the grounds of the case, as we saw in the press conference that they conducted jointly, is the right to free speech, which is basically their First Amendment right. So they are going by their constitutional rights to fight this case, and which is rightfully so in many ways, because these laws, I mean, Georgia is not the only one that has it. There are, I think, about 22 other states that have it already in many ways that actually penalize people and or firms in one way or the other for advocating BDS. So what it effectively does is infringe upon people's right to express themselves, even if it is in opposition to a certain kind of activities by another foreign country. And this is being done to protect a foreign country and to penalize American citizens most of the time. So in the implication would be to reaffirm that constitutional right, because in many ways you can actually see in the United States talking about Israel has always been very taboo in many ways. You don't have mainstream politicians, not many, talking about it. We have had cases of Ilhan Omar being framed as anti-Semitic, in even Bernie Sanders, who himself is Jewish, just because they speak at various different degrees about Israel's crimes against Palestinians and its occupation of Palestinian territories. And this will actually push a certain, discourse and discussion that is sorely needed in mainstream United States about why United States support Israel with billions of dollars in aid, despite what it does to not only its own citizens, but to an entirely colonized nation that it occupies effectively. So that is what you can see the larger effects of it will be.
Sure. Thank you, Anish. In a historic victory, the left-wing Sinn Fein has emerged as the second largest party in the Dail, the lower house of the Irish Parliament, making a considerable wedge into the century-long two-party rule in Ireland. The general elections to the 39 multi-seat constituencies across the country were held on February 8, Saturday, to elect the members to the 160-seat Dail. The elections witnessed a 62.9% turnout. This election has been seismic and historic and has been driven by the demand for a change by the people, Sinn Fein said in a statement. As results were declared on February 10, Monday, the Sinn Fein registered a thumping victory by securing 37 seats out of the 42 it had contested with 24.53% of votes. In the previous elections, held in 2016, the left-wing party had won 22 seats. The incumbent Fine Gael has been able to secure 35 seats in the current elections with 20.86% votes compared to the 47 seats in the last Dail. The centre-right Fianna Fáil has won 38 seats and 22.18% votes, 7 seats less than its performance in the 2016 elections. The victory of Sinn Fein is attributed to its pro-people manifesto for change that promised to take steps to tackle the issues of wealth inequality, affordable housing, healthcare and education for all. There has been widespread anger against the major establishment parties in Ireland. The Fine Gael government led by Leo Varadkar and the Fianna Fáil led by Michael Martin, as they failed to address the problems of rising inequality, the attack on labour rights and the increasing hate crimes in the country. The austerity policies implemented by Fine Gael and Fianna Fáil have further exacerbated the people's discontent with the establishment of parties. As Sinn Fein, rising popularity became evident, the corporate media attempted to discredit the party. Several media houses launched desperate attacks on Sinn Fein before the elections over the party's links with the Provisional Irish Republican Army, IRA, which was involved in the fight against British rule during the Northern Ireland conflict. With no party able to achieve a simple majority of 80 seats to form the government, all eyes are currently focused on Sinn Fein's leadership on whether they decide to form a minority government with the support of the Independents, 21 seats, the Green Party, 12 seats, the Social Democrats, 6 seats, the left-leaning People Before Profits, 5 seats, and the Labour Party, 6 seats. Fianna Fáil may also raise a bid to form the government with the support of the Independents and the minor parties. That's all we have for today's episode of International Daily Roundup. For more such stories, visit our website, peoplesdispatch.org, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Thanks for watching.